Another great European night at Celtic Park, played amidst an absolutely wonderful atmosphere. It's had everything except the outcome we're looking for. Let's hope we get it in the half hour of extra time. Let's get back out there once again with Craig Patterson and Paul Mitchell.
For the third time in 22 years, Celtic bring a 1-1 draw home from an away leg. Back in 1985, they lost here against Atletico Madrid by 2-1. Back in 2000, having returned from France, won apiece with Henrik Larsson scoring, they lost after extra time at Celtic Park. 7 years on, the prize, the place in the Champions League group stages. And can Celtic find a way to get through? Gary Caldwell is wanting his teammates to be a little bit better. Nakamura. Infield on to Donati. Celtic, if you're just joining us, have 11. Spartak Moscow have 10. They've lost Martin Stranzel, sent off for denying a goal-scoring opportunity. 5 minutes from time. Venegura Hesselink going through. The Dutchman on the ball, gives it away. Mozart flicks it on. Titov. Havlicenko now the lone striker. Torbinski plays it infield. Marchenko watches a little stumble on the far side. Once more the ball played away. McManus sweeps it forward. Madura wants too long. Venegar Hesslet on the header. Kovac quickly back. Mistake play to Koza. He's played exceptionally well. Come all the way, Celtic pick up again. Comes McGeady. Nakamura, two of them on that left hand side. Brown have made a good run. Forward onto McDonald it goes. Now to McGeady. Three in the box for Celtic. McGeady going for the byline. Trying to get away from Shishkin. That's a corner.
Good play again from McGeady. I think he's starting to fancy his chances against Shishkin. Every time he gets one on one, he's heading for that byline. The defender did well to get back and get in the block, but the pressure remains. Nakamura going to try and whip one of these free kicks in.
Celtic thinking about a change. McManus coming forward. Nakamura from the left hand side swings it in. Tito gets it away, breaks onto Naylor. He'll just roll that back onto Nakamura. Controlled on the left foot. Dington. Well, it was one of the Scott McDonald and a goal on one.
I just don't understand what happened there. I think he saw it very late because Venegar Hesselink missed it, but even then you figure he's got to react from there. Anything on target's a goal.
Brown on to Wilson. Wilson again into the box. Roman Šiškin away once more. Taken down by Donati. Here's McGeady on his right hand side to Nakamura. The two are working in tandem on the same flank. Here's Donati, good play, driving across Nakamura. The thin red line still requires to be broken. Here's McGeady, chips it across. Vinegar Hesseling! The tumbling header, agonisingly wide.
Tremendous effort, it's good play wide right again from McGeady. Just nicks in there, gets the ball in, and Vinegar Hesseling gets across his marker. That's a fantastic header, just a foot wider than near post. Good ball in, great header, so unlucky.
Well, Scott McDonald saw this come in from Nakamura, but did he see it late? No, just off the shoulder. Vinegar Hesseling had won like that in the first half. Kalinichenko is preparing to come on. McGeady can't get there. Tito, the captain. Torbinski, does he have some running left in him? Havlicenko. The Russian attacks will be few and far between, but they'll try and make them count. They do it onto Mozart. Pavlichenko will ball it. Kristoff, this could be his last action. He's getting ready to be taken off. The electronic board appears. Vladimir Bystrov, who was at Zenit St. Petersburg for 5 years, a useful pick-up by Spartak Moscow. And he sees that his number is up. And he'll wander off the field of play. Maskin Kalinichenko, the Ukrainian, will replace him.
Yeah, you can see Bystrov, I'm sure, knew he was going off, and he got himself as far away from the dugout as is humanly possible, and he's taking an eternity to get off. He lit up this game early in the first half, but he just looks like his legs have gone. His pace is his asset. Without that, he's nothing to offer, so he's got to go. When you're down to 10 men, you need legs out there, because it's going to be hard work for the 10 men.
Another player who's featured against Scotland, Kalinichenko, former Dnipro player, his seventh season now at Spartak, part of the cup-winning side in 2003, the last trophy picked up by this Russian side. Mozart onto Titov. What a night at Celtic Park. So no particular rush, they will take their chances from penalties, I'm sure. Titov. Infield it goes. Kalinichenko. Shishkin, who's not always been so great at the back, tries to feed one forward. And that came off the head of Gary Caldwell.
Mark Wilson's behind him. He really should know there's no danger there. Shout to Gary Caldwell, leave it. There was no problem. Caldwell didn't know what was going on behind him and did what defenders do. He just cleared his lines.
Kalinichenko with the corner. He won't take this short. He'll try and ping this one in. The changes being made. And Suraski is introduced. The goal scorer, Scott McDonald, goes on. Your thoughts on Scott McDonald tonight?
Well, he scored a fantastic goal, but he did miss a couple of real snips. You know, a couple of opportunities that normally, on a good day, he would have finished no problem.
Kalinichenko knocks it in, and across it goes. Well, that was an interesting piece of play. Torbinski had made a run, but it was neatly across by Dedura. Chip forward, Zanowski tries to get involved. He's got a great pedigree. He's scoring in Europe for his Polish side, who's a tackle. He's yet to get off the mark in European terms for Celtic. Mozart sends it across. Kalinichenko. Away by McManus. Kovac gets in there to do it. Number 70. Pushed forward. Past the fullback. To Kalinichenko. It's a good play. Titov, the heart. What's up there? They recapture the passing game. The Russian league leaders. Torbinski. On to Mozart. Titov. Mozart again. On the left foot. Fairly horrible drag. Well, the SPL highlights, which you would have been able to watch on BBC2 Scotland at 10 o'clock, will now be shown at 20 past 11. We will be moving over onto BBC2 just before 10 o'clock. We'll walk you through that. Ackle ball, Celtic with McGeady. McGeady picking up. Zaraski wanted it, McGeady's going for goal! Well, I'm not saying he didn't connect badly, but that's a throw on the far side.
When he first picked up the ball, he wanted to play it in the box, and there was only one Celtic player, only Venegar of Hessling, so he decided he had to do it himself, cut back onto the left foot and went for power, and it came right off the outside of the boot.
Spartak Moscow throw. Only loss in the qualification for a Champions League group came back in 1997. Little touch, it's going to be a free kick. Celtic look a little bit frustrated And it certainly was a free kick. Spartak Moscow doing some more paperwork. Uyanatsev is getting ready to come on. Uyanatsev, 29-year-old Russian, got the goals against Spartak, for Spartak against Sporting Lisbon. He's clearly not ready. And the referee has given a yellow card to Torbinski for not going off the field of play. I think he's a little bit fortunate. The player wasn't ready. Uyanatsev comes on, and Torbinski sees the yellow card.
Yes, a strange one. I think he realised there was a problem on the bench and he put the brakes on. The referee spotted it and he's right to give him the yellow card, because by rights, if you're going to make the substitution, the manager should have had the player ready. He wasn't ready and they had to go through with it. They tried to work the referee just to buy themselves a few seconds and it's cost them a yellow card.
The fourth official had withdrawn the board, but the referee's showing no sympathy. And Nikosa knocks it away. Celtic with it. Numerical advantage in terms of men. The scoreline stubbornly locked at one apiece. Back through for Zuranski is offside. He's not had the best of times, Banjic Zuranski, but he is a proven goal scorer.
Sometimes just it takes a goal for a striker to hit, you know, a real streak of form, and a goal tonight in a game of this importance could just be the thing for the Polish international. First thing with Celtic, have got to find a way through. It's been very difficult to get even a look at the goalkeeper since the Russians lost a man, because they have no intention of throwing people forward. They've got two banks of four, the back and the middle, and they're just going to make it really, really difficult for Celtic to break them down.
Kalinichenko on the angle, knocked away by Wilson. Pavlichenko onto Mozart. They're tracking back there by Wilson, and that is going to be a corner. Again, it's another chance for the set play. Yanitsev came forwards, and Wilson clipped it out of play.
I'm just looking for a bit of ambition here from Spartak, but they're going to keep four players out of the box. Celtic have got everybody back. Why they have so many away from the goal, I've no idea, because this is a chance. They won't get many.
Kalinichenko sends it across. Celtic knock it away. Hooked in the air by Zuravsky. Wilson tries to track across. May break the way of Red. Again, they might try and get this in quickly. Shishkin sends it across. Kalinichenko trying to get there. Now Celtic coming forward. Nakamura. Let's put the brakes on. Zuravsky. Bit of patience from Celtic. 2.5 minutes. First period. Seems like really yet to carve out a memorable chance. McGinney shooting horribly wide. Donati onto Nakamura. Donati. Naylor plays it across. Zuranski with a back header. Kabura just sliding in to get away. Pavlichenko held up well. Tito. Mozart outside him. Kalinichenko. That's a poor, poor pass. McGinney for Celtic. Going to go to Heslick, holds the line. Ball to slip through. And so easily back to his goalkeeper. And that is going to be offside. Derek Riordan is preparing to come on. I think it'll be Aidan McGinney. And the board confirms that. Aidan McGinney comes off.
Well, he's very popular at Parkhead, despite the fact he hasn't played an awful lot of games, but he's a lad who knows where the back of the net is, and anything from 35 yards in, Riordan is capable of picking off goalkeepers. So Gordon Strachan has certainly moved to get a bit of firepower on there.
A minute to play before the turnaround. It's always supposed to be an immediate turnaround. There's always a little bit of lagging. One or two of the players. Wilson tried to get into Benigura. Heslick kick off. Kovac sends it out wide. Kalinichenko doesn't pull it down. Again, Celtic build. Nakamura. I wonder how much he's thinking about those chances that he had. Another firmly in the back of the mind. to Brown. Brown. Here's Wilson. Wilson on to Nakamura. Nakamura with a little twist and turn on the right foot. Lead off. Wilson driven across. Good header away. Shishkin that time. Radin tries to ping it back over. Suranski sends it out. Donati wasn't set for a shot. Radin nips him well. Did it. Radin goes for goal. Played once for Hibs in Europe. He scored in that match. And on his European debut for Celtic, he comes close.
That's textbook Derek Radin coming in off the left-hand side onto his right foot, which is his stronger, and lets fly. Misses by a yard, but that lifts the crowd. That gets them involved. And Spartak defending well, but Celtic just looking like they might have enough up there to break them down.
1 minute of added time for the substitutions. Again, Celtic pick up. Kovoric not overly troubled. Celtic will be furious with the way they lost the goal. Valinchenko. Mozart trying to cling for the ball there. Celtic pick up. Goes out of play, and that could well be it for the first period of stoppage time. And there is the whistle. Another 15 minutes have come and gone. And it's another 15 minutes that the men from Moscow have repelled Celtic. Penalty shootout or a winner?
I think Celtic have enough on there, especially against 10 men, to get another opportunity. Whether they take it is a different matter, because if you want anybody in the end of a chance, one of them with the goalkeeper, I would take Nakamura. He's failed to finish. Maybe it's time for somebody else to step up to the mark. Zarabzi could use a goal. Derek Radin could certainly use one, and they have the fresh legs. The Russians will be tired. They're having to work extra hard now because they're a man short. Celtic will look to use the pace and the fresh legs up front just to break them down one time. And if you can get through, the big goalkeeper's had a great night. Celtic have got to find some way to get the ball by him. Penalty shootouts, you don't want.
Celtic last won an extra time back in 2000 against HJK Helsinki. Previously, they've lost two ties, the last two ties to go to extra time. You think back less than 12 months, they lost in Milan, and they also lost the FA Cup final against Porto. Perhaps things will go Celtic's way in this 15 minutes. The Celtic fans are playing their part. There are a handful of Spartak Moscow fans here. They'll be watching the numbers in the Russian capital. Now Rarda pushes it across into Donati. Brown. Into Nakamura. Nakamura. Is he pushed over by Mozart? No. Now the angled ball through. Well, Lee Naylor is in trouble. Celtic have got one substitute remaining. Lee Naylor is down, doing a bit of stretching. As the ball gets pushed across, Ivanichenko has to concede the corner. So Celtic have a look. McManus and Caldwell come forward. Well, the Russians aren't going to leave anybody up, Craig. You may as well get everybody in there.
Yeah, they can't afford to. Lee Naylor looks like a bit of cramp. He's had to work hard during the game here. Got a ton of time in the first half. You know, you've got to try and get Bistro, who's a flying machine. It takes out your legs, and now he's paying the price.
Nakamura with the corner. Celtic looking for gold. And with Hessling and McManus getting each other's way, rather. So I'm on that far side. Another old step over. Brown. On to Donati. Little ball played away. Nakamura. LRD getting ready to come on. If he's needed, Celtic continuing to try and press. Naylor for Celtic. On to Nakamura. On to Donati. Donati holding on. Welcome to viewers on BBC Two. where you're watching Celtic against Spartak Moscow. If you're watching now on BBC One, please turn over onto BBC Two, where you will see any of the action. Brown and Mozart go head to head. Join us on BBC Two for all the action.
Yes, Scott Brown just got late there, wasn't happy with the challenge from Mozart, went head to head, and it's crazy. The referee is across, and thankfully he's taking no action. It would have been easy to book both players there, but Lee Naylor continues to struggle. He's down stretching again, but I think he's raced me well, Biron.
Bernardet has never played in Europe for Celtic. What a moment it would be for him to come on. Lee Naylor will not want to go off if he can help it. Celtic physio just speaking across to Naylor. Celtic with a free kick. Nakamura in. It's inviting for Venegura Hesseling. Just will not drop Celtic's way. Arlachenko knocked it away. Returned in by Wilson. That's a free kick. The referee, good referee. He just gave it that second to see if the ball would create anything for Celtic. It didn't. Gary Caldwell. Back in field onto Wilson. Celtic looking for a winner. Wilson tried to find it. Well, he really cracked it, Mark Wilson. Never scored for Celtic, but he certainly gave it a go there.
Yeah, took a quick free kick. Mark Wilson couldn't see a pass, thought might just be his night, but the goalkeeper knew it was going wide early. No need to touch it.
Other than senior goals, that would have been a nice way to reach a dozen. Lee Naylor. Well, Celtic want the change to be made. They've been a little slow, perhaps. Well, the referee has given the free kick for the little push. They will want Bernardet on, and that is going to happen now. And Lee Naylor continues to try and stretch, but he sees that his number is up. And the left fullback has given his all tonight, Craig. You'll just hope that the next game he plays in Europe is in the Champions League.
Well, he's had to work hard, but you can't have passengers at this level with the money that's on offer. Somebody who can't run could cost you a goal, and a vital goal like that. Bernardet, we know he can play centre-back, he's played full-back, he's got a lovely left foot, so Celtic don't lose anything at all bringing the youngster on.
So Bernardet comes on. Celtic with their best ever start under Gordon Strachan in the SPL. Previously they'd lost one of their opening four matches, unbeaten so far this season. Finding it hard against Spartak Moscow. Kalinichenko. Kalinichenko moving in. Tries to drive it across! Arthur Boris with a touch! That was vital. Wonderful piece of play from the Ukrainian.
Brilliant play from Kalinichenko. I mean, he knocks the ball in. I knew Boric was under pressure. I think he's going to try and flick it over the bar. All he's managed to do is flick it by the far post and almost right into the path of a Russian attacker.
Boyarintsev was waiting across. Here comes Nakamura. Here comes Brown, pushing forward. Scott Brown, out wide. Wilson clips it in. Tadura gets the ball away. Celtic continuing to press, looking for a winner. Venegura Hesselink can't get there. The ball almost broke down. Shishkin again has presented Celtic with opportunities. Bernardet knocks it on. No way through for Radin. Kalinichenko sends it away. Here comes Titov. Arlachenko has taken up a good position too. Kalinichenko looks up. Mozart yelling for the ball. Kalinichenko again though. Plays it across. And McManus away. Just 9 minutes to go. Nakamura, Celtic moving forward, looking to join Rangers in the group stages of the Champions League. Here comes Scott Brown. Out wide, Venegura Hesseling on the left foot. Right down the throat of the goalkeeper, who gladly swallows the ball.
Decent effort, but it's going to take quite an effort to beat the goalkeeper. He touches it back onto his left foot, strikes it low, strikes it well, right straight at the goalkeeper. But here's the chance, Melly. Brilliant ball in. Boric flicks away. Ooh, just by the far post.
Back to the hand of Arthur Boric. Celtic would be chasing two goals. Back for the boot of Nakamura. Celtic would be through already.
Not often you can say that Nakamura missed what you would regard as a real Giltez chance.
Fair play that time by Spartak. This will either be remembered by the Celtic fans as a great night, a memorable night, or really one of the worst. It could all go down to penalty kicks. Only one Scottish side has ever gone through a European tie by winning. And kicks from the penalty mark, that is Rangers. Celtic and the others have never been successful. That may have to change tonight. Anoday. Left foot crossing behind everybody. Oh, Sarada. Just caught out slightly. Yanisev comes across. Yanisev looks up. Valachenko is in the middle. He's taking that for a walk. Guy Caldwell stumbles and falls. The whistle had already sounded.
I think he was just heading for the corner, looking to run down the clock, trying to keep the ball up there as far away from his goal as possible. Celtic did really well. Scott Brown got back 40 yards and allowed Gary Caldwell just to pick the time, make the challenge and win the ball.
Nakamura pulls the ball back. Nakamura flicks the ball on, out to Brown, then out wide. Wilson struggling to keep it in, does so, just stuck to the line. Zaraski on to Wilson once more. Nakamura, lovely touch. Brown should go for goal. That comes off the hand. Brandon goes across and the referee gives the penalty. Kovac with a handball and Celtic have the spot kick. It was a cracking drive from Scott Brown and the referee had no hesitation.
And the ball comes back here. Scott Brown, he sizes things up. He strikes it well. Out comes the hand. I don't think the referee sees it. The linesman makes the decision. And from there, you've got to figure he's spot on. Spartak have missed one. Can Celtic finish this game by scoring from the spot?
Vinegar Heslick had a bit of practice on Saturday from the spot. The number 10, £10 million at stake. A place in the Champions League. It's going to take some Dutch courage. Vinegar Heslick for Celtic. Oh, he rattles the crossbar! That goal is leading a charmed life. From penalty kicks, the ball get knocked away, Zurawski. Well, the Dutch courage failed him there.
Well, he went for power, he smashed it, and he's only succeeded in smashing it off the crossbar. And you look at him, he's absolutely distraught. Goalkeeper, all sorts of antics. Went to really batter it in the top corner, and he's just got underneath it.
If Celtic don't go through tonight, Vinegar Heslink will be hitting another type of bar very heavily. Donati. Ball comes back onto Nakamura. Celtic seeking redemption. It was a gift, an absolute gift.
Well, and the biggest problem is that will really put a spring in the step of the Russian players who might start to believe in that's our night. But from there, I thought he was going to pick his spot. In the corner somewhere, goalkeeper was dancing about. He put his foot through the ball and he couldn't keep it down.
That looks sensational if it goes in. Gordon Strachan. Well, there'll be a list of players going through his mind. Four penalty kicks. Vinegar Heslink may well have just dropped off that list. And Celtic will be tempted to just leave him alone. Donati, you would think, would take one. Scott Brown. Manus, the captain, may well do.
It's players who are confident, players who think or decide they want to take one. They're the guys, and it takes brave people out there in this situation.
4 minutes to go. Kalinichenko just overruns the ball. Played through by Kalinichenko. Harry Pendry Bloss whitening up the crowd. Celtic on the field. They've had a numerical advantage throughout this extra time. They've not made it count enough. Donati. Moving forward. Zaraski came short. Wilson. Donati's made a great run, but it's been well covered in the end. Now Brown goes sliding in. Titov gets it. To the other side, Kalinichenko, the Ukrainian romping through. Kalinichenko tried to come across, Celtic trying to move away. Kalinichenko again, Titov might leave that. So Armour, there's a decent shot on him, tries to knock it across, and easily just ebbing out of play. It looks like Celtic Park is going to witness a penalty shootout.
Well, normally it's skill that will decide a tie of this magnitude. If it goes to penalties, it's going to come down to nerve. Who's got it on the night?
Celtic's last penalty shootout unsuccessful against Valencia. Zurawski. Donati. Pushed through, trying to work it through. Zurawski. On to Caldwell. Celtic leaving it late. Raarden looking for it. Lenarchenko, but it was a push from Derek Raarden.
Not a great idea. Oh, he's been booked. He's had a go at the referee and he's picked up a yellow card, Derek Raarden. You could see it was an obvious push. And with defenders under pressure, all he can do there is head it out for a throw, head it back into the mixer, or give you a corner. And Derek Raarden, the minute he put his hands on him, the defender thought, I'm going to get a free kick here. And that's another 30 seconds wasted.
Well, the last time Celtic drew away from home, the first leg in progress back in 1996 against Kosice. We won at home with a goal from Jorge Guerrero. Tonight it's been frustrating. The goal they gifted away, the penalty missed. We're going to get a Hesselink. Lenarchenko sends it wide. That's a terrific pass. This could be. Bojanicev had the opportunity to send his side through. He scored twice in Lisbon last year. He should have scored in Glasgow perhaps.
Well, the ball through was absolutely fantastic. And when you watch his first touch, he gets it on the chest. He's actually set it there. And he's gone for power again, and he's blasted it into the Celtic fans behind the goal. What a chance.
Under 60 seconds. And the free kick will be given. Derek Raarden continues to argue Celtic have the free kick. Donati being waved away. McManus being told to get up there. Martin Boric thought about taking it, and it's a bit daft. Celtic do need to keep somebody back. 30 seconds and counting. Angled ball, played into the box, easily away. Lenarchenko just got the ball. Now here's Nakamura. Nakamura sends it across. Lenarchenko plays it away. The penalty shootout looming. Can Celtic have one more go on goal? Dan O'Day. But the referee says no, he's ended it just short. Well, a little bit tight for time there, the Italian referee, Roberto Rossetti. Well, Jan Venegura Hesselink was gifted the chance, he couldn't take it. We will go to penalty kicks. Celtic 1, Spartak Moscow 1.
Well, this is the game which really has had just about everything, some of which we didn't want, and you have to feel for Jan Venegar of Hesselink. A golden opportunity with just 6 minutes left to put Celtic in front, and he hits the bar just as Pavlyuchenko had hit the post earlier in the match for Spartak. So both sides have missed a penalty. Spartak, remember, down to 10 men, and after a game with unrelenting excitement, it comes down to what is really the lottery of penalty kicks. Let's just take a look at the two goals which have given us this extra time and penalty kick situation. Celtic going ahead through Scott McDonald. Dreadful mistake by Shishkin though.
Yeah, actually he was playing well for Celtic all night, and Boris Shishkin, he was but Scott McDonald, I mean, Scott McDonald, you've got to see, he's had 3, 4, 5 chances tonight, as has Nakamura, as has Venegar of Hesselink. I mean, Celtic had enough chances to win the Champions League, never mind this game. And it was, I think, over the piece. You know, they probably deserved this thing to go in at half-time in the game level. But over the piece, I still think Celtic made far more chances.
I agree with that part,
Who's got the psychological advantage here, Alec? Either of them?
Well, Celtic will be hoping the crowd give them the energy for this. They'll try and do their damnedest to put off the Russian goalkeeper, and they'll be cheering on their own players to try and get through this penalty shootout. So, I'll go for home advantage, and I think Celtic really did really extremely well in the second half, and in extra time things just petered out for them a wee bit, and sad for Bob Hesselink to miss that penalty.
Oh, that's, well, you wonder now, will he take one in the penalty shootout?
I think you want your strikers, if he is your natural penalty kick taker, you probably do want him to take him again. I mean, Gordon will be asking who's confident just now. I mean, you're guessing people at Riordan, maybe Nakamura, Zarafsky, you know, he's a forward. Scott Brown's not lacking in confidence either, is he?
No, and I think Gordon will be telling the players, be confident, just get up there, get decent run, hard and low. I think hard and low, the only mistake Hissling made was putting height in the ball, and I think if he'd hit it the way he'd hit the weekend's penalty or the recent one he scored, if he hits it hard and low, it's a goal.
It's one of these situations I've always felt with, that the pressure's all on the table. There's no pressure here really on Stipe Pletikosa or indeed on Artur Buric. If they pull off a save, they're a hero. If they don't make a save, well, no one really expects them to. The pressure's on the penalty taker.
Yeah, the likelihood is one of them is going to run away a hero tonight. And if it's great saves, then fair enough. But if it's, you know, hitting the crossbar or past the post, it's always a bit of a disappointment for them, because I think goalkeepers live for their moment well, it's not exactly the sun because it's night time, but I mean, they do live for these moments. And Boric, I mean, he's a difficult goalkeeper to beat. He's been in great form recently. I think he's a lot of very good saves tonight, so he'll be fairly high in confidence in himself. I don't think he was at fault with the goal either, so yeah, he's going to be a big and important person, but it's the people that are confident enough to walk up and take a penalty here.
Well, that's what I was going to ask him, and Alec, as a coach here, so what do you do in a situation? Have you got your list of five penalty takers, or do you wait to see who's confident, who's still on the pitch, who fancies it? Do you leave it as a late decision?
Yeah, well, I think some teams may arrange the penalty takers before it, but you tend not to think that way, because you say, right, let's not tempt fate, we don't want to go to penalties, let's win it in normal time or extra time. But then when it comes and you haven't done any preparation for it, people say, well, why didn't you practice these, or why didn't you pick the five? Only when you lose, of course. But you need five lads who'll step up to the plate there, be confident, and dispatch the penalty with a little bit of power. I always feel a little bit of power.
As a boss, you don't want to look into the eyes at the end of the game and think, does that player want to do this? So beforehand, you just don't know how they're going to react to the pressure. This is a massive pressure here.
Well, as has been said a million times before, it's a horrible way to lose, but how else do you settle a match which has now been played for 210 minutes and has finished 2-2 in aggregate, 1-1 at Celtic Park tonight, a game which, as I say, has had just about everything. Now it's going to come down to a number of penalty kicks. May not be 10, may be more than 10, but let's hope that that Celtic are able to come out on top. Back to Paul and Craig.
Thanks, Diggy. Celtic got one penalty shootout after a first leg away draw back in 1971-72. They lost against Inter Milan. Pletikosa and Boric wander together in the penalty box and have a shake of the hands. Arthur Boric will be the second goalkeeper, and Gary Caldwell steps forward. Started the last two matches. Couple of goals for Hibs last season. The 12 yards at times seems like it's an awful lot further away.
Yeah, and it is down to nerve. You've got to be strong. You've got to pick the corner and go for it. Or alternatively, sometimes a smash down the middle is as good as anything.
Gary Caldwell, the first of the penalty kicks. Beautifully dispatched by Gary Caldwell.
Pace and direction, went for the corner, goalkeeper guessed right, couldn't get there, perfect kick.
Forward comes Mozart, the Brazilian. One goal this season, up against Artur Boric. Saved that penalty from Saha last season. Mozart with the left foot. That was clinical.
Ah, that's every bit as good as Gary Caldwell's, and under real pressure, Boric goes the wrong way. Fantastic penalty. Two poor ones during the game. Two absolute beauties to start off the shootout.
The man who's won 71 caps for his country, Shinsuke Nakamura. A little bit of composure. Except Pletikosa, born and split over 60 caps. Experienced goalkeeper. Nakamura waits. The whistle is gone. The slow step up. It rattled the bar. He's trying to claim it was over the line. It didn't look like it. And the silence around Celtic Park confirms it.
Well, I'm not sure if he's claiming it's over or whether he says the referee moved early, but smashed off the bar, doesn't cross the line, and it's just been one of those nights for Nakamura. From 35 yards in, he's deadly. Tonight, he's missed from 12.
Sadly, it's an Italian official on the far side and not a Russian linesman. Titov, the captain, the flags furling behind him. Titov runs up. I could have saved that. Terrible penalty.
Well, he's gone for the very casual run-up. He's run very straight. He's tried to open his body up. Artur Boric guesses right. No pace on it at all. Good save from the goalkeeper. We're back to level.
That is a gift back to Celtic. Jan Benegur of Hesselink will step forward. Rattled the crossbar. What a moment for him. This takes guts. Benegur of Hesselink. That's what he wanted to do the first time.
Well, there was a pressure penalty kick. He knew, I've missed one in normal time. He had the guts to step up again, and that is another absolute beauty. Top marks for the Dutchman for stepping up to the plate there.
Roman Pavlyuchenko, he missed two. He rattled the post. The third penalty for Spartak Moscow. Pavlyuchenko, oh, it's as calm as can be. Two apiece.
He deserves the same praise as Benegur, because that's quality. He's just dinked it down the middle. He missed a normal time. He was under pressure. And how cool was that? Brilliant.
Celtic have never won a penalty shootout in Europe. They've lost both by 5-4. Into Milan and Valencia back in 2000. Derek Riordan for Celtic. Right-footed, steps up. Oh, nestled in the corner. That was a work of art from Derek Riordan.
Wow, that has just nicked the inside of the post. I don't care where the goalkeeper goes, you don't save that one. That is top draw penalty kick.
Now the return of Florin Soava, 29-year-old Romanian internationalist. Another old kiss for good luck. He doesn't look distracted, he looks focused. Oh, superb as well. And the noise just dies instantly.
Well, I mean, the quality's been tremendous. Boric, I guess, is right. He's got a chance, but you just can't get to that. That's too good. Another perfect penalty.
Magic Zurawski. Three apiece in the penalty shootout. One miss apiece. And Zurawski's name is being chanted round the ground. Three apiece. Zurawski, there was never any doubt, like a bullet shot into the back of the net.
Not the most subtle, but how effective is that? Smash, back of the net, goalkeeper nowhere, and now the pressure really starts to build.
Sudden death. If it's in, we continue. If it fails, Celtic are in the Champions League. Ask him, Kalinichenko.
Celtic players, and what it means to the club. It's big money, it's big teams, and it's where everybody wants to be. It was a long night, but they got there in the end.
Well, they all hug and they cuddle. It's been some night for Celtic. There's been many heroes out there. A man of the match, perhaps.
Well, I'm going to give it to a steady Eddie. I mean, there was a lot of decent performances, no outstanding, but over the 120 minutes, I thought Steve McManus at the back was rock solid, gave nothing away, kept it simple, did his job, captained the side, and now he's looking forward to taking them into the big time.
He was punching his teammates at half-time. He's punching the air with joy now. Arthur Bonich, the hero for Celtic. The Pole denying his next-door neighbour, the Ukrainian. And Celtic lift off into the Champions League. Marvellous scenes. Celtic will play Champions League football. Well, you've got to feel for a manager on a night like this.
Well, it's a lot easier if you're a player, but as a manager, you rely on others to get the job done for you. He's gone through all sorts of emotions through there, but you can see what it means at the finish. He was out there first, congratulating every player. Means a lot to him, means a lot to the club.
Well, Gordon Strachan said before the match, the money didn't matter. It's all about the prestige. Plenty of handshakes between the two teams, very sporting. Spartak Moscow came to Scotland. They wanted to go home in the Champions League. But it's the Celtic fans who've been in great voice who sing the song of success. What a sweet song it is, too.
Well, it just makes such a difference because, you know, we love to see the big, big teams coming to Scotland, and Rangers and Celtic are going to face Europe's elite. The players test themselves against the best. It's good for the club and it's great for the development of our players.
Arthur Boric, the hero in the end. Celtic go through, one apiece on the night, 2-2 in aggregate. Celtic win the penalty shootout.
Ah, that's why this is the wonderful game that it is. The contrast between the unmitigated joy and relief for those Celtic fans and players and the abject despair of the Russians. The Big Yuns certainly enjoyed it. And Celtic 4-3 winners on penalties after a game which had a red card, missed penalties in normal time, missed chances by the plenty. And at the end, it's celebrations as Celtic go through to the Champions League. You can't ask for much more than this, Alec, can you?
No, I think we tipped it. We said that the energy of the Celtic fans would give them that extra power, and they sucked the energy right out of the Russians, you know, with the two misses there. So, fantastic for Scottish football. Really delighted with the show and all the Scottish lads over the piece over the last two nights.
Here's something you might be interested in. The poor lad who missed the penalty, Maxim Kalinichenko, he's a Ukrainian. Let's hope that's an omen, eh?
Well, if you finish above the Ukrainians, then we're one step closer, but obviously we have a battle ahead, but fantastic stuff tonight.
But that's fabulous, Pat. Those pictures are just how much this game means and how much this club means to so many people.
Yeah, and there have been so many magical nights in Europe at Celtic Park, and I mean, everyone's got their favourites, the Celtic supporters, and just people who love football and love sport. But as you said, I'm trying to figure out what this game didn't have, because it did have everything you want in a game of football. The excitement, the mistakes, the chances, sending offs, penalties. You said you didn't enjoy penalty shootouts. I love them. I think they're hugely exciting. And you just accept it. If you can't get two teams separated, that's the way to do it. I know what you mean, but I mean, that's what sport's all about. It's about pure excitement. I really don't know if it gets any better than something like tonight, and there's so much at stake at the end of it as well. Not just the money, it's obviously the glamour of all these big teams that are going to come to Celtic Park and to Ibrox now. It's been a great two nights for Scottish football.
It certainly has. And what Celtic will take out of this, Alec, because they've taken on a very, very good side over two matches and come out on top.
They were a good side, and we said that, but during the second half when the Russians had a little bit of passing movements, it was important Celtic never panicked then, and they come back strong in the game. Sometimes we've got to look at ourselves, our own boys out there. Scott Brown, for instance, he looked like a man out there, you know, amongst the Russian elite players, and you know, people would say still young and inexperienced, but that's going to increase his experience tenfold.
I think every single player will have something he can remember out of this, you know, whether it's relief, players like Nakamura, etc., because the chances he missed. But what must Vinegar of Hislink think as well?
Yeah.
Incredible, missed a penalty that could have pulled through, but got himself out of jail at the end.
Exercised his demons.
Unbelievable scenes here at Celtic Park. You can only imagine just how good Gordon Strachan feels. Here he is.
Gordon, what a fantastic game of football, and what a fantastic way to win it.
I think I said to you before the game, it wasn't going to be a nothing-nothing. It'd be an open game. Didn't realise it was going to be that open, but what a fantastic game of football. You know, we've seen great games here over the years, but that, to live in the memory, just an exciting game, and it never got quiet any time. You know, when they scored, maybe in the penalties, it got a bit quiet. But I thought our mental strength, because they played excellent in the first half. And I was saying to the lads, their mental strength, not their ability, their mental strength, they come back from them playing so well, the Moscow side, for us to do so well in the second half was absolutely terrific.
Even at times when maybe they were getting down in the flanks, you defended so well as a team, played so well as a team, that must really please you.
Yeah, that was in the first half of doing that, and to be fair, I thought the two wide men were terrific. The boys were saying in there, and I said beforehand, that Moscow were better than anything we played against at home last year here. In terms of performance level, I thought they were fantastic.
And when Jan Vinegar of Hessling, of course, missed that penalty during the game, your head must have gone down just a little at that point.
No, I didn't. I still thought we'd win. Somehow, I just felt, and you get that sometimes, that it was our time. And I think our energy, as I said in the first half, their pace was fantastic. We got over that and came back. Mentally, we were strong, so that helped us physically. And I just thought it was a terrific game of football.
With Rangers winning last night, also in the Champions League draw, Alec McLeish just said in the studio there, it's a great week for Scottish football. You must agree with that.
Yeah, big Alec, and the big Alec takes on now, and we wish him great success in international level. And, you know, get two teams into the qualifying, yeah, into the group stage is absolutely fantastic. And for Alec now to go on and do a wee bit, you know, we need to give him all the help he can get and all the backing he can get, and that'll be terrific.
Okay, Gordon, congratulations tonight. It was a superb win. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Well done.
Thank you.
Superb win indeed it was, and nice to hear that in his moment of triumph he can think about what you've got ahead of you.
Well, I think that means he's going to rest some players ahead of our internationals. Just like the favour I've done him and Walter over, yeah, the last couple of weeks. But yeah, no, it's
a bit of a responsibility in you now, man. Rangers have done it, fantastic. Celtic have done it, you better get a couple of good results here. Don't want to put any more pressure on you. Just before we go, let me tell you, by the way, that Arsenal are through as well. A 3-0 win tonight at the Emirates against Sparta Prague. So they go through in a 5-0 aggregate, just as Liverpool did last night. Rangers, as we know, have seen off Red Star Belgrade. And tonight, in the most utterly absorbing 120 minutes and penalty shootout, Celtic 2 are through to the group stages of the Champions League. It's been a night to remember here at Celtic Park. We wish them both well when they get into the Champions League, flying the flag for Scotland. And, of course, we wish Alec well with those two Euro 2008 qualifiers coming up. From all of us at Celtic Park, good night.
I'm going to go into business with one of you. And to start a business with somebody you don't know, I can assure you, it's a bit daunting.